I wanted to try using a silicone funnel. It would make it easier to pour resin into the molds, and the resin wouldn't stick to the silicone. So I had a funnel about the size I wanted. We're going to cast silicone in here, then we'll cast the other side, then we will use the silicone mold to make the silicone funnel. I'll pour in here, and then I will vent out here. I was down to my last bit of silicone when I mixed this. I'm waiting for another drum to show up. So this was not quite full, and I took some pieces of silicone from an old mold. I cut off strips and stuffed them down in here, and that raised that level a little bit. You can see them sticking through the surface. And that's one reason why I wanted to grind up this old mold material so it would mix with this rubber. It would be more consistent, more homogeneous. I poured the top part of this mold. I used new silicone to go down inside the funnel and to cover the smooth surface of the funnel. And then this upper portion, I used silicone mixed with some of that recycled silicone that I ground up earlier. Now we'll take this apart and see how it looks. These are the two halves of the mold for the funnel. That's the original funnel. Pretty thin section in through here. This will go down on top of there. Make sure it's well seated. Need to spray both sides of these with a mold release. And in this case, we're going to have to get some mold release up inside this area. The mold release is not required if you're casting resin in the silicone, but it will make your mold last longer. But in this case, we're going to be casting silicone in silicone. That does have a tendency to bond together. So we will use mold release. This part goes on there. Put some rubber bands on here. Make sure that this center section is sitting in there where it's supposed to be. So the silicone or the resin would be going down through this hole into this cavity and pushing air out ahead of it. After I shake that around and get as many bubbles out of it as I can, I'll put it back in the vacuum chamber. We'll pull the vacuum on here, see if we can get any more bubbles to come out, then we'll put it in the pressure pot. The volume of plastic in this funnel is not very great. Trying to get a rough idea of how much material I need to mix up, I filled this glass to the brim with water. Set it down in here, and then submerge slowly the funnel in the water, and the displaced water is overflowed into this container. Put this small cup on here, tear it out. It ends up being 50 grams. If that was pure water, that would be 50 cc's. So I know I need to mix up that much silicone plus maybe 10% more. That should be sufficient to fill that mold. I poured the water into this cup, came up to about this point, and I added roughly 10% more volume. Put that on the scale. We're going to tear out the weight of the empty cup. And I filled another cup to the same point with silicone, part A, and that weighs 89 grams. We'll call it 90 grams. Now this is mixed in a ratio of 100 parts of A silicone to 10 parts of B catalyst by weight. We have 90 grams of silicone. We're going to measure out 9 grams of catalyst. We have 90 grams of silicone and 9 grams of catalyst. Now you need to stir this for about 3.5 minutes. When you stir this for 3.5 minutes, you're beating in a lot of air, and supposedly the silicone does not need to be degassed in a vacuum chamber. We're going to pull a vacuum on it anyway. Scrape the bottom, scrape the sides. And if you have a large quantity of this, this will keep you busy. It's fairly thick. Put the lid on the vacuum chamber, turn on the vacuum pump. the process of pulling a vacuum on this, that silicone will more than double in size. You gotta keep your eye on it and don't let it overflow your mixing container. Once it has grown to its maximum expansion, then collapses, you're pretty well done with it. There's still going to be some bubbles coming out of there, but you've gotten most of the gas out of it. So we'll go ahead and release the vacuum. To make life a little easier, I put this funnel in here, and I'm going to pour this from fairly high up, what they call a high pour, and that allows any bubbles that might be in that silicone to work its way out. I'm not sure how this is going to work, or if it's going to work. Hopefully, once we get a column that's high enough in there, it'll start pushing itself down into the mold cavity. That's a very small cavity down there. And this is a fairly viscous material. I'm not sure how successful this pour will be. Now, if you're pouring a resin, it's quite a bit thinner. Okay, I'm just starting to see the silicone come up to the top of the mold. I'm going to pour this out of here. We'll put that back in this vacuum chamber. I don't have a lot of time to play with this, but I'm going to do this a few more times. That in the pressure pot. Pressurize this to 45 psi and leave it in there overnight. It takes about 4 hours for the silicone to cure, but we'll just leave it in there all night. I pulled this apart and I'm pleasantly surprised. My pressure casting of the silicone mold has produced a very smooth surface. And it appears I do have a complete casting, although it seems to be pretty thin. Probably going to be too thin to be of any use, actually. Way too thin. I had a little trouble getting this part out of the mold. Actually, I expected some problems with that. The idea was to be able to hold this, pour resin in here, and when the mold filled, you'd be able to squeeze this, shut it off, so you didn't spill resin all over the place. To make a mold of a thin, detailed item like this in a thin section, and to end up with a perfect casting with zero surface defects, zero bubbles, then that, as a casting, is an absolute success. As a usable project, this is a total failure. That's more of a condom than it is a funnel. On to the next project.